This is Isabelle Litzler, the place to be to develop your skills and grow your potential. So today I wanted to share with you three sectors that are in demand in Switzerland, again, where you can find some job opportunities in job boards. So what are these three sectors? It's going to be my three tips today. So the first sector that's actually in demand, but again, you have to put that in perspective. It's not going to be everything within a sector. It's going to be specific jobs. Is a financial professional. So if you're in finance, definitely you have your chance. So some of the skills that are sought after would be a mix of finance with IT. So if you're able to do data interpretation, financial planning, forecasting, reporting, interim management within finance, then you would find probably a few job openings. So again, it's not just any finance, because sometimes people contact me. Usually, I would find that maybe people are more bookkeepers or something like that. So this is not exactly what the Swiss market is looking for. I would say probably your qualified financial professional with maybe some additional skills. So I would say one way to find out or to increase your market potential in the job market is to have your field plus plus, meaning that you're a marketing person plus you have some knowledge on certain tools, or you're also a good communicator, or you know, you mix and match different types of things. So it used to be where it was good enough to just be a good professional in one thing. I would say one way to differentiate yourself is to be a plus plus. So again, you're a finance person plus plus. Number two is IT. IT is definitely growing. There's always, in Switzerland, there's always needs for IT. A lot of people from different countries are coming to work because they have knowledge of certain tools and they're usually very well educated. So for example, IT analysts, administrators, systems analysts, programmers. So these people are in demand. For example, you could work in IT management, in security. I always talk about web security. There's a huge, huge growth of digitalization, which again requires IT skills. So again, if you're a well-rounded IT person, and again, thinking always about this plus plus, you speak a few languages, you're also a good communicator, you have experience with key companies, you have a better profile than someone who's just an IT person but doesn't have maybe the languages, maybe they know some tools, but it's not the tools that companies are looking for. So you have to be on top of what companies are wanting. One way to find this is to look at job boards, is to see what are some of the software that's required and go for the in-demand type of tools. So cloud, business intelligence, all of these are in demand. So again, this is based on some research I've done in the Swiss market. And number three is the commercial sector. But again, this is a huge domain and not everyone will have the same market attractiveness. So for example, in the research, they talk about receptionist and so forth. I'm not sure now they would be so needed, but probably people who are good salespeople, who are good business developers. So if you're a startup, you're going to need your finance person and your marketing person typically. So that goes with what I'm saying today in this video. If you're a good finance professional, probably you have some potential to get a job with a startup. If you're a good marketing person, especially online marketing, then you also you're in a good space. So again, when we talk about jobs that are being eliminated, I would think that if you're a good digital specialist and you understand how to do campaigns online, then you would have a better attractiveness than someone who's maybe a bit too much, you know, on doing marketing, but the old ways, maybe like events marketing wouldn't be as attractive now unless you do it fully online. So examples would be assistants in Switzerland. They need assistants as well, but again, it has to be a very qualified assistant, languages, you know, software, you have experience with big name companies, etc. Project management is big at the moment as well, but again, very, very classified project management like Scrum Master, PMP. It's not just general assisting. So if you're good with projects, if you're good with languages, with IT, also support with legal, I would add to the list on number four. So it's the bonus of today, What's recruiting in Switzerland is also international organizations. So if you're a diplomat, if you're a worldwider working for the UN or ReliefWeb, all these kinds of things, for all kinds of missions, then there's always needs for jobs in Geneva, mainly to work there on projects, doing the analysis, doing the technical work. There's always a flux of job openings there, especially consultants, technical consultants, and so forth. So, if I recap, number one, finance professionals, but again, very educated, very specific, mostly very specific. Number two, IT professionals plus plus. Number three, commercial sector, I would say with an emphasis on the digital world. So if you have skills around digital, you have more chances than someone who's from the commercial sector with non-digital skills. And bonus number four would be international organizations. So anything from the technical consultants to right now working with health is huge. So if you're a health specialist, you would actually get two markets. You would get international organization plus the pharma sector. So I hope this video was helpful. Let me know what you think. Was it helpful to help you figure out what type of work you could find in Switzerland in this day and age, January 2021? Hope you're doing well, and I will talk to you soon.